A strain of porcine circovirus known as PCV2 has affected pig populations across Thailand and the rest of Southeast Asia. It spreads rapidly and compromises the animal's immune system, causing health complications impacting on size and weight. This not only impacts Thailand's pig production, but also the economy on the whole. Sarisa is a pig farmer on the outskirts of Bangkok. She fears the impact of an outbreak of PCV2 on her business.
สวัสดีค่ะชื่อนางสาวสุริตาเกลียวกรรมนะคะทําอยู่ที่นี่มา 20 ปีแล้วค่ะเป็นหัวหน้าแผนกเหล่าคลอดค่ะอยู่ที่นี่เป็นฟาร์มเดียวนะคะคือเราก็จะง่ายต่อการดูแลโรคเราก็จะไม่ค่อยมีคนข้างนอกก็จะไม่เข้าค่ะเราก็อยู่กันเองดูแลกันเองค่ะ
15 million pigs are produced annually in Thailand, with the pork industry a key asset to the national economy. But such a high concentration of pigs also means the country is more susceptible to the outbreak of disease. The symptoms of PCV2 include weight loss, breathing problems, diarrhea, and skin irritation or discoloration.
I'm Dr. Pete. I work as a veterinarian for swine business for around 11 years. Now the report showed that most of the Thai farm has circovirus inside, including the outbreak and non-outbreak farm. Now in Thailand, if you have a circovirus spreading inside your farm and you don't have vaccine, you cannot survive. Your business will be gone. Now other people can do maybe 5% damage from the production. But if you stand at 30% damage of your production, surely you cannot compete with others. Let's say the farm that has a 3,000 sow, you will have around 100 or 150 workers. They will lose their job. And as a farm owner, you also lost of the income for your family too. It will destroy the whole economy because the economy in the rural area of Thailand will still rely on the agriculture.
A need to produce its own vaccines to combat strains like PCV2 fits into an ongoing and nationwide drive for sustainable development. The Thai government has instigated Thailand 4.0, an economic policy aimed at promoting and supporting innovation in research and technology. Supported by the government, Biotech is a research institute looking into the country's capability to produce its own animal vaccines.
Well, Biotech is involved in a lot of research, both in agriculture and in medical problems, as well as in various other areas, environment and so on. So long as it involves biotechnology, and the vaccine for pig is one of the long interests that biotech has in animal production, as well as the animal diseases.
The need for Thailand to be able to have this capacity to produce, manufacture, or even do research and development for their own vaccine is quite urgent. So in our lab, people have different backgrounds. Some of them are microbiologists, some of them are immunologists, and some of them are cell biologists, some of them are, like me, biochemists. And we all pitch in different expertise, different angles at looking at the same problems.
It's really a very challenging task. I mean, we have not really done this to the extent that that the vaccines would be ready for the market. We have very good experience in bringing Thai scientists together. That's what we do all the time. But now in this project, we're working together with the University of Kent and other partners to really make it a real, real vaccine that you can use. The product is right here and not just in papers.
The project brings together a consortium of leading Thai and UK scientists with the aim of developing a process for Thailand to be able to mass produce its own animal vaccines. The project is led by Professor Colin Robinson and Dr. Alison Walters from the University of Kent.
The idea behind this project is that we're going to produce recombinant proteins that are used as animal vaccines.
Recombinant protein is a protein from one organism that's produced in another. So, for example, we're going to take a protein from a virus that infects pigs and we're going to get E. coli to make it. So we're kind of using E. coli as a factory to make lots and lots of this foreign protein that it doesn't normally make, that we can then purify, extract from the E. coli in large amounts, and then use as the vaccine that we need for the pigs.
The idea in a nutshell is that we perfect a system at small scale, and then the Thais use that system and scale it up to 500 liter capacity. And then they're in a position to produce their own vaccines. Animal vaccines have to be cheap or the farmers can't afford to use them and they won't use them. So this is all about making the process efficient so that the Thai companies can market this more cheaply than importing a vaccine from Europe or the United States.
Thailand's ability to produce animal vaccines will not only positively impact its food and agricultural economies, but will undoubtedly have an impact on the vaccine market in Southeast Asia. Studying the needs assessment for animal vaccines in Thailand is Dr. Fatim Laka from the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine.
So the global pig industry is valued at $69 billion, forecast to be valued at that in 2026. And the vaccine part of that is going to be valued at $9 billion. Okay, in 2016 it was $6 billion and it's forecast to be growing. Now, Southeast Asia forms a small component of that whole, but 65% of pigs are found in Southeast Asia. And what happens is that whilst at the moment most of the vaccine and animal pharmaceutical industry is in Europe, and whilst the largest component is there, the forecast for where growth is going to be in this part of the world, in this region. And therefore, if we can produce our own vaccine, especially for pigs, then it's going to produce a huge benefit and growth for Thailand itself in reducing poverty, and improving innovation, technology and industry.
The consortium of Thai and UK scientists have come together at Biotech to evaluate their progress and plan the next phases of the project. Upscaling from the lab to the mass market won't be easy, and while the consortium includes top experts in their respective fields, they will have to collaborate effectively to get the task done. With the University of Kent spearheading the project and production of recombinant proteins, University College London will focus on scale-up processes and purification, and Imperial College London will be in charge of all the analytics.
So one of the main challenges is the scalability. The product has to be exactly the same in the small batches all the way up to the larger batches which will finally go onto market.
Basically, the role of analytics is to prove that the vaccine is what it is meant to be and to ensure therefore that it is safe.
Our focus is on the downstream aspects of the project, particularly related to the manufacturing objectives.
A lot of research can be on a very fundamental level, which is hugely important too, I think, but may not immediately lead to some outcomes that you can grasp and see immediately.
Thailand has invested heavily in bringing effective vaccines from the lab into mass production. The team have come to the NBF, a state-of-the-art facility built for the purpose of manufacturing vaccines and medicines on an industrial scale.
Building up NBF is about building up capacities here in the manufacturing and control of biopharmaceuticals and vaccines, but also about trying to drive local research more and more towards translational research and commercialization.
So this is exactly the machine that Colin talked about today in the morning, about running the PCV2D using this bioreactor. It can run up to 30 liters at a time. And what we are trying to do right now would be to scale up PCV2D activities from Colin's lab using Amber's conditions and transfer it here. Here you probably can come up with 100,000 doses. And then you kind of need to think about what you do with all the materials.
Our visit to NBF, really where we get down to the nitty-gritty of, you know, the real details of what we're going to do next and what people need to coordinate on.
We are progressing very rapidly. There's still a lot of work to be done. We still need to do a lot of trials. We still need to pass regulations.
So fundamentally, we need FDA approval in order to sell these and in order to get these vaccines onto the market.
So the Thai FDA agreed to meet us so that they could understand a little bit about what we do. And this was the first meet and greet meeting, really, where we're trying to set the scene.
As Thailand is venturing into new territory, the impact could be groundbreaking, opening up new possibilities for Thai exports. Due to the high-profile nature of the project, discussions with the FDA were kept private. The outcome from the meeting was positive, with the Thai FDA asking for further evidence before moving forward.
From these projects, we can move up, you know, from just the basic level of being able to do some technical development for our own benefits, you know, to being able to produce products that can compete in the world market. This will not be just good for the financial purpose, but more importantly, for our own capability, you know, in science and technology, so that we will have more people who are able to look after the scientific progress, not only in this country, but to help, you know, for the whole world. ¶¶